I'm Aparna Bamzai, University Assistant Director of the South Central Climate Science Center. In this video, I'll be talking about the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, or IPCC, and how it can produce assessment reports that have both the agreement of leading scientists and the consensus of participating governments. In 1979, the United States National Academy of Sciences convened an ad hoc study group on carbon dioxide and climate to examine how to project the climatic consequences of increased atmospheric carbon dioxide. In their conclusions, the study group found no reason to doubt that climate changes will result and no reason to believe that these changes will be negligible. The report brought together unbiased viewpoints from the most eminent atmospheric scientists of the era and is widely considered to be the first modern assessment of climate change. Coinciding with the release of the 1979 report, the first World Climate Conference convened in Geneva, Switzerland. Scientists from all over the world representing a wide variety of disciplines met to discuss research on climate variability and change and how to conduct integrated impacts studies. There was wide consensus that there needed to be an international scientific effort to review studies related to greenhouse gases and conduct assessments of the rates of increases for these gases and of the effects of such increases, but disagreement as to whether such an effort should blend politics and policy with science. It wasn't until 1985 that an advisory group on greenhouse gases was formed to begin such an effort and develop a mechanism to provide the resulting information to a wide audience. By 1988, this group was slowly phased into the IPCC, a scientific body formed under two United Nations organizations, the Environment Program and the World Meteorological Organization. The IPCC does not conduct original research or monitoring activities. It only synthesizes existing research and data into summary reports. The IPCC has published five assessment reports so far: 1990, 1995, 2001, 2007, and most recently in 2014. In order to represent the variety of disciplines involved in climate research, the IPCC has three branches: Working Group 1, the physical science of climate change; Working Group 2, the impacts of climate change; and Working Group 3, options for adaptation and mitigation. Each working group is co-chaired by a scientist from a developed and a developing country and creates its own volume for the assessment report. Each volume summarizes the state of the science on that topic area, notes major scientific improvements since the last report, and identifies important scientific questions that still need further research. Chapters within each volume typically have two coordinating lead authors, 10 to 15 lead authors, and a large number of supporting contributing authors. All of these researchers work on a voluntary basis to assemble and compile source information into the report. Authors must give priority to sources from peer-reviewed scientific journals, but are allowed to include non-peer-reviewed sources, such as reports from government agencies, given that they meet certain quality standards. Experts from all over the world are then invited to comment on and review the draft report before final edits are made. The 2013 Working Group 1 report was over 2,000 pages long and cited over 9,200 publications. A unique feature of the IPCC assessment reports is that the authors also create four different supplementary summary for policymaker reports, one for each working group, and one that synthesizes information from all of the working groups. While scientists approve the content of the working group volumes, government delegations vote to approve the content of each summary for policymakers report line by line. Over a special four-day session, each sentence is displayed on a giant screen and is discussed at length by the delegates. Sentences can be sent back to the author teams to be rewritten, but they must still be scientifically accurate and conform to the content of the full report. The delegates must approve each sentence unanimously. As you can imagine, this process can be quite slow and is often a delicate balance between science and politics. In the end, though, this means that every member nation of the IPCC approved the line that warming of the climate system is unequivocal in the 2013 Working Group 1 summary for policymakers. As the community of researchers working on questions related to climate change has grown larger, the complexity of the assessment process has increased dramatically. Scientists have already begun work on creating a new set of climate model output for the IPCC's sixth assessment report, anticipated to come out in the early 2020s.